Chinese President Xi Jinping makes his first visit to Hong Kong in about 3 years. Xi arrived in the Special Administrative Region on Thursday, where he met with Hong Kong Chief Executive Carrie Lam and other officials ahead of the 25th anniversary of the city's return to Chinese rule. He is expected to lead the celebrations today, Friday, and inaugurate Hong Kong's new government. The move is seen to showcase the Chinese Communist Party's power over the business hub 3 years after it unleashed a harsh crackdown on pro-democracy protesters. Xi claims Hong Kong has been reborn, and with one country, two systems policy firmly in place, its future will be better. Chinese President Xi Jinping ready to work with the Philippines' new leader. In his congratulatory letter, Xi told Ferdinand Marcos Jr. that he is willing to work with him to continue writing a great chapter of China-Philippine relations. Chinese Vice President Wang Qishan, who represented Xi during Thursday's inauguration, also presented a four-point proposal to enhance bilateral ties. According to Chinese state media CCTV, Marcos told Wang that Beijing was Manila's most powerful partner and that his administration is willing to deepen the country's participation in China's Belt and Road Initiative. There was no mention of China's increased military activities in disputed waters, but Japanese Foreign Minister Yoshimasa Hayashi also met with Marcos, said the Philippine leader agreed to cooperate with Tokyo to maintain and reinforce rules-based maritime order. Hayashi added Japan will support the Philippines' effort to enhance equipment of its Coast Guard.
Other foreign diplomats personally congratulated President Marcos Jr. at a post-inaugural reception at the National Museum. The papal envoy spoke on their behalf as Dean of the Diplomatic Corps to pledge their cooperation with his administration.
The Filipino people have placed their trust and their hopes in you. Their hopes for a future that is prosperous, safe, equitable, and just. We too, in the international community, harbor the same hopes for your presidency and for your nation, and that we pledge our cooperation and collaboration with your administration in achieving the success of your mandate.
Marcos expressed gratitude to foreign governments for seeking to boost ties with the Philippines under his leadership.
We can only go from here to strength and to strength and to strength. And for that, that is what I look forward to, that the day will come when we can say that we have built upon the strong foundation that we came upon.
A Thanksgiving concert for President Marcos was held on Thursday afternoon at the Menjola Peace Arch near Malacañang. Music veteran Randy Santiago and comedian Bayani Agbayani and rapper Andrew E were among the performers. The hosts initially said Marcos would be appearing at the event, but he ended up skipping it. Around 2,000 people attended the concert.
Tayo po talaga namin. Tsaka kasi siyempre siya po yung binoto namin.
Anong nararamdaman bigo ba 'yan?
Medyo malungkot pero okay lang, nabasa kami, enjoy naman kami.
Masaya pa rin. Mulat umaraw. Rain or shine, andito kami pa rin.
Now, protests also greeted the inauguration of President Marcos. Before Marcos took his oath, the whole Plaza Miranda in Manila was teeming with members of various sectors from human rights, transportation, the youth, and public health.
Ang Plaza Miranda kasi historic ito pagdating sa paglaban sa diktadurang Marcos. Kaya nga maganda rin mairaos dito bilang bahagi ng ating pag-alala doon sa nakaraan ng diktadura.
Ang hamon sa atin sa pag-uupong presidente ay dapat bigyang prioridad ang kapakanan at kagalingan nating mga manggagawang pagkalusugan sa usapin na nakabubuhay na sahod, security of tenure, pagdagdag ng mga regular plantilla positions, para sa lahat ng nagagawang pangkalusugan.
Meanwhile, Marcos supporters say they are not affected by what critics say against the new president.
Since day one na pagkampanya po, lagi po akong sa kanya, nakasubaybay po ako sa kanya. Mas gusto ko po siya ang manalong bilang presidente po talaga.